What's up, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. Oh, hold on. Bring it back. Hold on. Hair. Cute. Giving what it's supposed to give. Period. Yeah. Anyways, welcome back to the channel, y'all. I am Amber Michelle. If you are new here, make sure you go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you'll be notified whenever I post a new video. And to all my returning girls, hey y'all, this is just, you know, me giving y'all insight on the natural hair situation. I am going into my natural hair journey phase of life right now, and so I ended up chopping some of my hair off. I cut some of my ends. No, you guys didn't see that because it was pretty ugly and I didn't like it. I just didn't like it. I'm sorry, I just didn't. But being that I did, you know, cut the dead ends off my hair, I decided to do this style as a little protective style. These are considered invisible locks, so if you guys want to see how I achieve this look, make sure you go ahead and keep watching. I'm about to show y'all what I did to achieve this look. Let's get right into it, and don't forget, like, comment, and subscribe, you know, and comment down below so we can chat it up, period. Hey y'all, here we go. So I used the Expressions twist up hair. I got the shortest length because I was going for a short look, and I literally only used these two hacks. That's it. I also used this All Day Lock Edge Gel Extreme Hold. I recommend it for the locks for sure. Of course, you need your comb and your brushes, and I got some clips to clip the twists, you know, until I was done with them. So, boom, we about to get into it. I'm sorry, let me stop. But I never really did the voiceover thing, like, on a full video, so y'all just bear with me. Just please bear with me here. But I did not blow dry my hair. I let it air dry because, like I said, we're on a natural hair journey, and that consists of no heat, baby, like no heat at all. So I just let it air dry after I detangled it by section, and then I twist them in little sections and put little ties on them so that they could stretch it out a little bit, so it at least, you know, make my hair think that I blow dried it, even though I didn't. That's what I was going for. So yeah, as you can see, I really didn't have no specific method to this. Like, I literally did it last night, put the twist in it, and went about my day. Oh, little length check, you know, something slight. And this is after I chopped my hair. Let's talk about it. Shrinkage is crazy, but let's talk about it. Like, so just imagine, you know, in a couple months, really a year, what my hair is gonna give. You know, but anyways, let's get right into this hair. I started by parting the back. I really, like, went through it, you know, carelessly, because it's like in my head, like, nobody's gonna see that for real. So, you know, I just did a little part, and the sections were kind of big in the back because I just didn't care that much. But yeah, I didn't want to record the back for y'all because that would have been too much for me, way too much. But here's a little view of how it turned out thus far, and of course I am going to show you guys, you know, in depth how I did the front. So boom, I started out, you know, parting in the front. I really took into consideration, because, you know, the front of your head, people can see that better or whatever, so I really took that into consideration. And I just took a little gel, really a lot, honestly, because my hair, like, needs it. In order for it to lay down, being that I didn't blow dry it, didn't put any heat in it, I need all that gel in the hair to lay it down. So yeah, I just parted it, you know, made sure my part was as crispy as it can be. You know, just y'all see the vibes. Like, y'all see what's going on here. So boom, after I got it, you know, y'all see how I got it looking real nice and crispy. I just used my clip to clip the excess hair back, you know, just so it's not in the way. And I also made sure to leave out some of my edges because I like to do my edges at the end. So I just left some of that out. Now, let's get into this install. So me, I know the invisible lock method is considered, you know, twisting up, you know, like a lock at the beginning of your roots, but that was just too much for me. My hair is too thick. It was not going. So I started out with a knotless braid at the root, and then I started adding this Expressions deep twist hair to the braid. And y'all see, can y'all see? I hope y'all can see what's going on here. Like, I just did like two little loops of that, added another piece just so that I didn't want like very skinny twists or locks, as they call them. I didn't want them to be mad skinny. So I added like two real fluffy pieces of the twisting hair. And you know, I braided it in knotless at the root. I really just did the knotless like two times around, and then I just started twisting, like went straight into the twist after that. Cause I just felt like that was an easier method for me, being that I have thick hair. Like if you have thick hair and you're not trying to put heat in your hair, I recommend doing the knotless at the root and then twisting it down and giving you that lock effect. So yeah, I'm just speeding through this part right here because it ain't nothing, you know, this part ain't nothing. You just twist it. I add my little gel as I go. You know, you get the gist of that. Boom, we at the end of the braid. All I did was just folded it up as whatever length you want. That's where you need to stop it and fold it up. But you know, you fold it up and you just wrap it around, like you just keep wrapping it around, you know, like a lock. I think that's why they call them invisible locks, because you wrap them up like a lock, I assume. I don't know, but but yeah, I just wrap that up, and then I grab me a rubber band and just seal it up at the ends just so that it's not done. I know some people, they put like hair glue on it, but I wasn't going for that, mainly because I just prefer to have the rubber band method so I don't have like that much of a hassle when it's time to take them out. I just came back on here to show y'all, you know, how far I've gotten. Parts looking nice. Yep. Not too big, not too small. Now we're about to get into the top of this crown because I feel like that's where most of my hair is. Child, parting this was too much. Like, I just had to cut that because y'all did not want to see how bad I was struggling because I'm tender-headed, for one. If y'all don't know, I'm tender-headed as TF, like anything hurts, and I'm doing my own hair and I still be hurting myself. So it just be a crazy situation. But anyways, getting back into this parting, you know, I really try to make sure that the front is as crispy as it can be, because like that's the main part that people are gonna see or whatever. So some parts I may just go back and redo them, you know, if y'all see that. Like I just want to make sure that the top slash front of my hair is on point. But you know, here I am just going back in, adding the braiding, the twisting hair into my head. And like I said, we're doing the knotless at the root method because, you know, girls with thick hair, you understand what's going on around here. Like, I watched a video of a girl like doing the invisible lock method, like the original method, and I was just like, no ma'am. Like, I did a few on my back, in the back of my head, with the original method, and I just felt like they were too loose, my roots are too thick, and it was just a no for me. So like I said, I highly recommend knotless at the root and then start the invisible lock. Okay, don't you ever switch it up. Okay, you guys, so as you can see, they came out really nice, clean and neat. Okay, the next step I do is, you know, you gotta moisturize your roots, and that's something that I never really did, so I'm trying to be more consistent doing that. So I'm just putting the oil all throughout my roots, rubbing it in, massaging it in, or whatever. Make sure, you know, hitting all the spots. And then the last step, of course, you gotta add your mousse or whatever, add that to your hair. Boom, then here is the finished product. So make sure, if you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe, and leave a comment down below, and I'm gonna talk to y'all later. Bye.